All right, so let me show you how to use TradingView paper trading as a stock market simulator. Now, first, let's talk about why you should use a simulator in general. So there are two main reasons for this. Reason number one is that you want to test your trading strategy or trading idea. So if you have a trading strategy, as you know, there's three elements to it. It is what to trade, right? What stocks or options. And then you want to know when to enter, and you want to know when to exit. So these are the three elements of a trading strategy. And you see, it doesn't matter what you're trading. If you're trading the Power X strategy or if you're trading the wheel, it doesn't really matter. You first want to test it to make sure that number one, you understand the rules so that you're not making any mistakes there. And B, you want to make sure that the strategy actually works. But there's a second reason of why you should trade on a simulator first. And this is to gain confidence. Because you see, whenever you have a new strategy, you might be wondering, does it work? Doesn't it work? Right? And this is when you're using a simulator and you test your strategy and you see that it works, you get more confidence because now you get some actual numbers. So you will know your winning percentage. Right? You will know your average profit and your average loss. You will know your drawdown and other important numbers. Anyhow, is this making sense thus far? So then let me show you a free tool that you can use as a simulator. So the tool is TradingView. You're probably familiar with TradingView. I'm using it a lot. If you would like to learn more about TradingView, go to rockwelltrading.com/TradingView. We'll post the link in the description here. So let me show you step by step how you can use TradingView as a simulator. Step number one, you need to connect paper trading. In order to do this, step number one, so you go to trading panel. Here at the bottom, you see trading panel. And when you bring it up, you can choose your broker and log into your brokerage account. As you can see, it's usually mainly Forex brokers, but you see on the very left side, you see paper trading. So this is step number one, you want to connect paper trading. There you go. So after this, step number two, you want to reset your account. And you might be wondering, why should I reset my account? I haven't done anything yet. Well, here's why. Usually you get by default an account with $100,000 in there. And I mean, that's cute, right? But maybe not exactly your trading account size. So it is very important that you mirror the paper trading with your trading account size. So therefore, you click on the gear icon here, and then you see reset paper trading account. And when you do this, you can actually say, what is your balance? So if you're planning to start with $10,000, put $10,000 in there. If you choose to start with an account of $20,000, do this in there. If it is $5,000, put that in there. So right now I'll put $10,000 in there because it seems that many traders are starting with a $10,000 account. So then you hit reset. So this way you see right now you have an account balance of $10,000 and an equity of $10,000. Way more realistic than 100,000. But again, every trader is different. You choose whatever your account is. So this was step number two. Step number three, now you do the following. For the order, you also have to adjust a few settings. And then we'll walk through an actual order here. But right now, right mouse click anywhere on the screen in your charts, right mouse click anywhere there. And then you see the fourth item, the fourth menu item is trade. When you click on trade, click on create new order. When you can click on create new order, you have an order ticket appearing on the right hand side of your chart here. You also see a gear icon, and here is what I personally use as settings, what I highly recommend. Uncheck show order price in ticks, check show quantity in US dollar risk, uncheck show quantity in percent risk, check show TP, that's target profit and stop loss, inputs in US dollar, and uncheck this one. Okay, so this is the basic settings in order to use the simulator. Now, let me show you exactly how to use it in conjunction with the PowerX Optimizer. And when you're using the PowerX Optimizer, as you know, this is the tool that I personally use. So for today, we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 stocks that came up. Now, you know my routine. If you don't know it yet, go to mytradingroutine.com. This is where I show you exactly what I do. But I quickly go through the list and look for stocks that have no gaps. And as you can see, the first one, AQST, has a gap. So I'm kicking this out. I don't want to trade this. CalX, the next one, want to see, are there any gaps? There's a gap here. There's a gap here. So not my favorite. Going to kick this one out. FEYE. So this one here also had a pretty big gap right here. So not the biggest fan. Again, I'm using several criteria here. My criteria are number one, gappiness. Number two, trendability. And number three, I want to see a nice P&L chart here. I did more videos on this. I'll link to it in the description. But let's just say that we want to trade plug, right? I mean, I'm just using it as an example so that you know how to do this. Now, PowerX Optimizer, as you know, what did we just say? A trading strategy tells you what to trade, when to enter, and when to exit. And this is exactly what PowerX Optimizer does. And now I'm showing you how to use the simulator in conjunction with PowerX Optimizer. So on the right-hand side, we see exactly how many stocks we want to trade, when we want to enter, and when we want to exit. So let's go to the TradingView simulator here. And the first thing I want to do is bring up plug as a symbol, because this is what we want to trade. So as you can see, now we have to fill in the quantity and where exactly we want to buy. And according to PowerX Optimizer, we want to buy, so this is a buy order, as you can see here, buy plug, but we don't want to buy it at the market. We want to buy it when it goes up to 1889. So this is the exact price that PowerX Optimizer tells us here. Now the quantity, we talked about it, 55, super easy. And then we can also specify our profit target and our stop loss. Now PowerX Optimizer gives you the values right here. As you can see, the profit target is $26.63. I can show this actually here on the chart with PowerX Optimizer so that you see, okay, somewhere up here is our profit target and here is our stop loss. So anyhow, we are plugging this in. So we want to have a take profit, and here we are not using pips, we are using the price, and we are using a price of $26.63. We can then also specify a stop loss, and PowerX Optimizer tells us when to get out of this position with a loss at $15.26. Oh wow, look at this. It's already showing it here. So as you can see, based on a $10,000 account, we would risk $199, almost $200, trying to make $425. So our risk reward ratio, as you can see here in PowerX Optimizer, is 1 to 2.13. So then all you need to do is click on buy Nasdaq after you have entered all this. And again, this is not being executed as your broker. This is a simulator. So you don't make and you don't lose any money. This is for testing your confidence, gaining confidence, and testing your trading strategy. So let's just say buy, and you see order is sent right now. And this is where you see, oh, right now we already got into the position because the price moved above 1889. So that's great. As you can see, now we have one position and we have two more orders in the market. And here is what our orders are. Our order is a sell limit order for our profit target and a sell stop order for our stop loss. Now you see our position here and we see our profit and loss appearing here in real time. So as you can see, it is super easy to use this simulator here in conjunction with PowerX Optimizer. So you also see that here you have a history so that you see what happened. So here we bought plug 55 shares at $18.89, status filled. We will get an account summary. You see right now we are already up $1.65. Hey, look at this. We are already making money. There's a trading journal, but the trading journal does not mean that you can put any information in there. The trading journal just means that they are telling you of what happened, that an order was activated, it was successfully placed, it has been executed. I didn't find this very helpful. Here you find the account history where you see, okay, what was the balance before and after you entered a trade? And there's also a notifications log that I didn't find that useful. Anyhow, it is super easy. You can now change the orders that you do have in the market here. So you can change them to a different price. As you can see, there's a little edit sign right here. So you see exactly what you have right now, what you bought. You have the working orders, you have the filled orders here. And now if you would change any working orders, for example, if you want to change your stop loss, you just click on the edit here and change it to any value that you want. By the way, the right way to move your stop loss is always closer to your entry price, never away. Never ever give a trade more room. It usually ends in disaster. But you see, super easy, you can modify it here, or you can just leave it as is. And the other working order, we can also modify if you want to take profits earlier. Are we already up? Are we making money, losing money? Doesn't really matter, because this here is the paper trading. So therefore, right now, we're making $1.10. Yay, that is awesome. Okay, anyhow, so this is how this trading simulator works. So summary, very important. First of all, why do you need a simulator? It is just to first test your trading strategy. Did you understand the rule, and does the trading strategy work? And then gain confidence so that you can do it risk-free. How do you do this? Super easy. Again, some preparation, three steps to prepare it. You connect the paper trading account, step number one. Step number two, you reset it to the account size that you are planning to trade. Step number three, you modify the order settings here. After this, super easy, you just pick any stock that you want. So let's just do another example here. For example, if you wanted to trade HL, Hecla Mining Company, would you like to see another example? Let me just show you another example here. Super easy, the way how we do it is we bring up the symbol HL, we right mouse click on the chart, and when we right mouse click on the chart, we can click on trade, create new order, and then we just plug in all the values from PowerX Optimizer here. So first of all, we are trading 526 shares right here. We want to buy on a stop order once the price goes up to $5.58. Right now, we are already trading above this, so I'm modifying this a little bit to $5.70 that I can place it, because right now we are trading above the $5.58 that PowerX Optimizer suggests. For the take profit, we are plugging the profit in from PowerX Optimizer here. So if this stock goes up to $7.82, this is when we want to take profit. If it goes down to $5.20, this is when we lose money. And as you can see here, we are risking around $260 trying to make $1,000. Now, for the time in force, I recommend that you do it for the day, because that these are the rules according to the PowerX strategy. We just want to make sure that we have the order in effect for the day. And that's pretty much it. After you've done this, you just click on submit here. And then you see that, let me just move it over, it has been sent. And now we have five Avg orders in the market. As you know, we already have the two orders that we had previously for the profit target and stop loss. And now we have another buy order for HL for another stock. Once this buy order is executed, then the two inactive orders for the profit target and stop loss will be activated. So as you can see, super easy to use. The best thing, it is free. Highly recommend that you're doing this. So let me ask you, what was this helpful at all? Because if you enjoyed this video and found this helpful, do me a favor and click on like so that more people will see it. And if you want to see more videos and tutorials like this, then click on subscribe and also hit the little bell, because this way you get notified whenever I release a new video. Also, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to share this video on Facebook, Twitter, or by email. Share it with somebody who could use this information, and I will see you in the next video.